Good morning, YouTube. It's Cherise here, and my skin is looking better and better every day. I'm super excited. So today is going to be a makeup tutorial, and I have the second half of a hair product review coming later today. I took out my braids last night and tried out a new product for a kind of chunky twist out. Who knows what style is going to happen? I was feeling really lazy and just kind of did something to my hair. So if you want to see how that came out, stay tuned later today. But right now, it's going to be a makeup tutorial. It's about to be at 6:55 a.m. And tonight, we are having the Miss Winthrop University NAACP Scholarship Pageant. And I'm doing makeup backstage, as I've said in a couple other videos that I've uploaded recently. So I'm just going to get ready and kind of do the makeup I'm going to wear tonight now, just because y'all know I don't like to really redo stuff. I'll just touch up before I go. So I decided that I'm going to use my NARS Velvet Matte Skin Tint with Broad Spectrum SPF 30 sunscreen just because I really like the way this looks on my skin. And this is in the shade Polynesia Dark 1. It is a little red for me, but using concealer it will make it work. So I'm just going to start with that much. And I'm going to use my beauty blender that I recently washed. It's damp to blend it out. I prime my face using my favorite primer, the ColorFX Mattifying Primer with Acne Treatment. And I'm probably going to do two layers of this. We're going to build it up. So now I'm putting some across the forehead, working in sections. Overlapping this side. And as we can all see, this color isn't the best match for my skin. It looks kind of pink on my skin. It has way too much red and pink in it. But like I said, with concealer and my powders, we will make everything mesh together. And I'm gonna go ahead and scoot this back a little bit, just so I can get the very edges of my hairline. I'm gonna wear a headscarf for the first half of today, because I wanna make sure that my hair dries, has time to fully dry. All right, so this side already has two layers. Some of my imperfections are still showing through. That's okay, because we still need to add concealer and powder. This product is medium to full coverage. I'm gonna do another squiggle on the side. I'm wiping off the lid using my beauty blender. But the fact that this is like kind of orangey, pinkish, salmony on my skin almost makes it like a color correcting skin tint, because it contrasts with my natural undertone so much. If that makes any sense, if you know what I mean. Which I don't color correct. I think just using a good old full coverage product, it kind of takes care of everything for you. I I already have an idea of the look I want to do and the products I want to use, so this video shouldn't be as long as mine normally are, unless it's just me taking my time with the process. This terrible pimple I have, like, right on the underneath of my chin is really annoying. It's right in the center. At least you can't see it from the front. And I also have this right here. And for the most part, my skin is looking pretty clear. Alright, so that's what that's looking like. Moving on to our concealer, I'll be using the LA Girl Pro Concealer in Beautiful Bronze. I don't know, I can't remember the title, the name, title. Oh my gosh. And we're using this to highlight and to balance out the tone of this concealer. And to add coverage. Of course, I'm doing under the eyes, down the bridge of the nose. A little bit onto the forehead. And I'm just going to work on these sections first before I go anywhere else. And I'm using the same beauty blender. I'm also taking whatever is left on the sponge on the top of my eyelid below. And then, of course, we're going to bake everywhere that I put concealer to help prevent creasing and just to lock the product in place. As you can see, it's kind of subtle on the forehead, which is more of what I want because I have a large forehead. So we don't want to highlight too much. I got my phone for me. I look so strange without eyebrows. So creepy. I'm kind of using the side that has no product on it to blend the sides of this concealer on the nose. And now we're going to conceal a couple other spots, like the cupid's bow. Not too much. We're gonna do a little bit in this general vicinity. You can see how it's helping it look better with my skin tone, even though it's still kind of reddish. That's okay, though. Well, it looks so beautiful on the skin. Like, this is without setting it or anything. It's so pretty on the skin. Just doing some more blending. Alright. But I'm gonna keep it spill. Let me get the chin. I wish I had more of my favorite kind of and I'm blending this line. I'm just going over it. As you can see. So first I start to kind of drag it down a little bit. This will just help make the contour pop. I might do a little bit of contour. I don't know yet. But basically we're softening it. We still want it to be sharp, but not stark. Is that a good word? Just kind of blending out the edges. It's definitely time to set this with powder. And the powder I'm going to use is, I think. I ordered some more of my favorite powders, but they just haven't come yet. And it makes me sad. We're gonna use Creamy Bronze Finish from Black Radiance. And we're going to use a cosmetic wedge. I really like this color. I think it goes with my undertone really, really well. But I was wanting to use the L'Oreal Pro Matte Infallible Powder in 700 Classic Tan. Is that what it's called? But I don't really have an abundance of that, but I do have like basically a brand new creamy bronze finish. As we can see, it is lighter than me. So we get to set this with. So I'm loading up my latex-free cosmetic wedge. I'm gonna pack this everywhere that we put concealer. Starting with the under eye. And I'm going to apply to the lid as well. If you have any creasing, go ahead and blend out your creasing. I have creasing on my eyelid. My eyelids crease very easily. So really, as you can see, it dries to such a beautiful satin finish. I really kind of don't even want to set this skin tint because it's so pretty. I just wish they had a shade that matched my skin better. Did it make me look pink? I'm taking the beauty blender to blend out the creasing on my eyelid. And then we're going to set that with powder as well. Bake it up. So I'm applying a generous amount so I look really scary and ridiculous. So we're gonna bake this region. And we're gonna use a little less powder, like not as heavy up here on the forehead region, but still generous. Oh my gosh, who's texting me? Of course, I've been spending 60 minutes on my foundation. On the bridge of the nose. Now you should look very interesting. Oh, Cupid's bow. Hey, what up? Mm-hmm. Okay. So now I'm baking, obviously. I feel like I should put a picture of myself on, what is that thing called? Snapchat. I'm just gonna use whatever powder's left over. On my neck. My neck is like the darkest part of my body. One of the darkest parts. It's darker than my face and my chest and everything else. Which is annoying. Alright, I look so scary. I'm sending this picture to my coworker. He will appreciate this. And Alexis Croy will appreciate this. Alright, so now what I'm gonna do is something you guys really haven't seen me do before. You're used to seeing me press in powder all over my face and skin, because I like to, because I have oily skin, I'm like, I need to make sure everything stays in place. But what I'm gonna do is take this e.l.f. kabuki brush, which is kind of a fluffier brush, all over face brush, and I'm gonna use my all over face powder. And the one I'm using today is from L'Oreal. This is the L'Oreal True Match powder in C6 Soft Sable, and I'm probably gonna mix in a little bit of C7 Nut Brown as well. I'm just gonna mix them on the brush. I'm just gonna pick up one like this, like so. Get it all powdery. I'm gonna go into both of these colors. I love my L'Oreal True Match powders. And I'm going to blend everything away using my all-over face powder. I'm going to do this one, too. So, like so. I'm basically going to start where there's no product, or where it hasn't been set yet, and go over everything. Like so. So going into C6, getting some of that C6. I feel like I'm talking about carbon, nerd. All right, and now I'm going into C7. And then we're gonna go to this side. And as you can see, I flipped it right here first and then blended it. Okay, that's my alarm to wake up, but I'm already awake. I've been waking up early. My mom texts me. She texts me that she loves me and sent me a nice little Bible message. Oh. All right, I texted her back. So picking up some C6, going into C7 as well. And I find that by doing it like this, it just helps everything blend together, and it helps to get rid of the excess powder and set the other parts of my face all at one time. So it's kind of like a 2-for-1. And now I'm going to go into C7, which is a darker one, nut brown. And we're going to kind of use this to contour. It's okay if it gets on my head, this head wrap. As you can see, I got some on there. Because I'm putting a prettier one over the top of this plain black. I just want to go to Starbucks and then go to my first and only class of the day before I practice and take a nap and then get ready for this pageant. Our washing machine is broken, so I need to find somewhere to go wash the dress I want to wear today. So, and I need to stop by my job as well and get my password reset so I can check the schedule. So that's kind of important. So like I said, I'm taking C7. And really kind of just and look how natural that looks. This just looks so good. I'm really happy. My skin just looks really smooth and perfect and flawless. That's what we want. I love these L'Oreal True Match powders. They work great. I just want to make sure everything's set. Everything is looking how you want it to look. I'm going to pick up a little bit more of this C7. And really make sure that I get this half of my face since I tend to neglect it. And of course, blend down onto your neck. So now we have our base almost all the way done. I'm not gonna contour with contouring powder because I don't want to be too strong today. I'm gonna be doing smoky eyes, a brown smoky eye. I'm not sure what color lip, the final lip color I'm gonna wear, but I know I want a brown smoky eye. This look is kind of inspired by Liz Live. If you watch her in one of her recent videos, like top 10 new lipsticks for deeper skin, her makeup look was super simple and really pretty. So I'm kind of going for that today. But now our base is done, minus highlighter. And I'm going to take C7 with me to the fashion show, and I'll have brushes to apply powder if I need it. Alright, so for highlight today, I'm going to use my favorite, of course, Black Radiance Ginger Snap on my e.l.f. complexion brush. I'm using a very light hand to apply this right on my cheekbone. A very light hand. I'm going directly on the cheekbone, as you can see. I'm taking it down pretty far. Yes, glow, come through. I'm using a very, very light hand. Why do I already have, like, tears coming through? Or, like, this little spot on my eye? I don't understand. It's okay though. My roommate texts me. I'll be right back. All right, so she left something. But I can't, and her door's locked, but since I work at the desk, I can technically get her key and go get the item that she left, but it'd have to be me since I work for the school, for the building. But the thing is, the desk doesn't open until 10 a.m., and I don't have a key to the office because I don't work the morning shift. So we're in a slight dilemma. But we're gonna work it out. Alright, so like I said, we're highlighting the cheekbones. Just right on top of the cheekbone. And I'm using a very light hand. I'm also gonna take this down the bridge of the nose. And I'm not gonna wait till the end to do my brows because I look so scared with that eyebrows. She needs her Letterman jacket. They're doing a 50s, is it 50s or 60s program? I think it's a 60s program today at her internship. She's at elementary school. And she has on, like, her poodle skirt and everything, and her whatever the socks are called that they wore back in the day, and her little, are they called Mary Janes? I don't know. Anyway, she's all dressed up for this, and she just forgot her Letterman jacket. For, like, I guess the final finishing touch. Caught in the Cupid's bow. But yeah, like after I add my powders and stuff, everything comes together. Like the color, it all works out. I notice a lot of other people are having the same problem where it's like too orange or whatever on their skin tone. I'm also brushing this through the brows and over the lid. You see that nice glow that we're getting? All right. So now we have our highlight and everything on. For blush today, I'm going to be using... I want to use my Black Radiance. The orange one. What is it called? Toasted Almond. I don't know if I can find it, though, in this bag of makeup. It's pretty intense in here. I might just wear the same one I had on yesterday, which is a pink color. But it's also really, really pretty, and it won't clash with anything. And this is Hot Raspberry from Jordana. If you're wondering why I'm so shy, it's because I have on, like, oil, the cocoa butter, like, oil lotion. It's supposed to be for babies, but I like to use it. It just leaves your skin really shiny and really soft. And I'm using the same e.l.f. complexion brush going into this blush. And also with a very light hand, applying that right onto my cheeks. So it gives a nice little flush of color. I'm making great time. I'm so really happy with the time that I'm making so I can go to Starbucks and eat. I've been telling you guys, I've been waking up so hungry. Like, I don't know what's going on with me. I just wake up hungry. I'm like, I need food. I'm like hangry in the mornings. Hangry is a cross between hungry and angry. Like when you're hungry, you get angry, so they call it hangry. That's me in the mornings. Like my stomach is just like, feed me. And I'm like, first, let me get this beat done because I'd rather just knock it out now. And I'm using a very light hand, that's the key. Major key. So now we have a soft flush of some pink blush. It's not too much. Our highlight, contour, everything is popping. That song always comes to my mind. So I think I'm done with the skin, guys, and I can move on to brows. So the foundation, the base of the face is completely going to eyes, brows, and lips. So for my brows, yesterday I tried out a new product. Well, it's not really new, it's just a different color than what I normally use. If I can find the black eyeliner pencil, I can never find it. That's a navy blue. I might just have to use this side of this one, which is okay. All right. And I threw both my sharpeners in this bag of makeup. Okay, so I just use plain old eyeliner pencils to do my brows from Wet n Wild. Alright, and I just need to sharpen them quick. I was digging for my sharpener. Found it. And like I said, I'm using this one. It's their Color Icon Kohl Eyeliner in Simma Brown Now. And this one is, I don't even know who this is from. This is from NYC, but it's a double-ended one with purple on one side because I can't find my black one that I normally use. It literally like broke, like there's no more eyeliner in it. I can't even right now. I can't even. There we go. So I got my brown nice and sharp, but I need black as well. I tried dark brown only yesterday, and it looked okay. But I prefer to have some black, I think, because that's all I'm used to. And my hair is really dark. I have dark black hair. Oh my gosh. I have no idea what happened to the black eyeliner. I see all the other colors. There it is. You always find everything but what you need. Alright. I'm struggling. Do I want a pop of turquoise or purple? I kind of want to do turquoise because diamonds are forever is the theme of the pageant. And turquoise is kind of like a diamond. Like, you know, you think of a diamond. Like the emojis is this color. So I think we're going to do turquoise as our pop of color for this look on the bottom lash line. Alright, so I have my black and brown pencil. Both of them are from Wet n Wild. My skin looks so good though. This side's more intense. Usually this side is more intense with the contour. Okay. I'm going to start with the brow. And if some of it falls off, just keep it. I'm following my natural brow shape, which is pretty thin. I'm just loving this combination of products. Well, that's my alarm to wake up if I don't wake up the first time. But no, I woke up at 6:15 today. Got some stuff done. Now I'm here. Doing the makeup. Like I said, I'm following my natural brow shape. Let me get a little closer. And this one has a better shape than this one. So it's always hard for me to kind of get them to match. They're a little lopsided right now. It's okay. Alright, so we have our brown kind of laid down, and now I'm gonna darken things up with the black and work on like the tail end. Yeah, my face is gonna be beat today. I love this NARS. Like, it looks so good. When I add my powder to it, it actually, like, comes down to my skin tone and everything. It looks so good on the skin. Love. I've been loving it. And my brows are snatched today, yes. All right, so now it's time to go back with the brown and really soften up the beginning of the brows. I'm using a super light hand. And sometimes I use a spoolie to brush through them, but today I did really good, like, getting them to look how I want them to look, so I don't need to use a spoolie. I'm just going over my face with my damp BB blender. Just because it's a habit. Not because I really need to. I'm kind of slanting this brow a little bit more at the beginning. But I'm loving the brows. Brows are complete. And sometimes I set them using some old kind of dried up mascara, but today I'm going to leave them as is because I'm really happy with how they came out today. Let's move on to eyes. I need to take these with me for the show tonight so I can do other people's brows and get them on fleek. All right, so for brows, like I said, brown, matte brown, smoky eye is the look we're going for. So I'm going to be using my two palettes, my Smashbox Full Exposure palette and my Anastasia Beverly Hills Shadow Couture World Traveler palette, because it has some really nice matte shades over here that I really like. So first we're going to start with this palette. I need fluffier, something fluffy. I mean, I guess I could use this. All right, we can use this. I'm going to use this BA Cosmetics 122 brush to get started in the crease. And I'm using the Smashbox Full Exposure palette first. And I'm going to take this brown right here. Why is this shimmery? And this color is not really going to show up on my skin, but I'm more so using it to set where I get eyelid creasing. Right in this inner crease area. Before I really get started with the shadows. Okay. So I've got that to set where I get it creasing. I get it like right in there. So it's not really for color or anything. All right, so now we are going into the World Couture Shadow Traveler. Now I'm going to take Fudge on the fluffy side of the brush that this palette came with, And I'm going to start to work this into the crease. Let me come closer so you guys can see.
All the way in.
And I'm using, excuse me, the color fudge. My nose. Oh my gosh. Okay. Of course, my nose will legitimately start running, but thankfully, I have a tissue right after. Inhales the tissue. Alright, back to fudge.
You can see I'm building this up into the crease.
Sorry, y'all. Alright, so now I'm just deepening up and intensifying the brown on the outer part by just adding layers, more layers of it, and keeping the inside more soft. Like so. I mean, I might add a little bit of black to this, I don't know. I'm kind of liking the dark brown. And it does have a little bit of shimmer to it, but it's mostly matte, as you guys can see. But there's a little bit of shimmers in there from just being mixed with other shadows. I can live with that. This is kind of just our crease color. I didn't really want to use an orange or anything as a transition because I wanted it to be like strictly brown. I'm going to take just a little bit of Noir, which is a matte black from this palette, right here on the very end, just a little bit. Adding that to this outer crease area before I go on with my lid color, which is very, very dark. And now I'm going to use that other brush that had that really, really light shade that I used to kind of prevent creasing. I'm just going to use that to soften up the edges. Because it's a really light brown. I'm just using this brush and whatever leftover shadows on it.
like so.
So now it's time for the wood color. And that color will be coming from the Smashbox. Full exposure palette. I was like, what is this palette called? And I'm going to be using... Which brand do I want? Let me swatch these real quick. That one's more grayish. That one's more of what I want. Okay, so I'm going to be using this dark brown right here underneath my favorite shimmery one eyeshadow shade. And I'm going to use... You're trying not to use your brushes because you have to do other people like that. I'm just going to use... No, I need something flat. What does this have on it? It has orange on it. The struggle's real. I'm going to use this synthetic concealer brush. Really, you could leave it look like this if you want to, like, or put another color, like, on your lid, but I'm going in with this dark brown.
And it almost looks black. This dark brown color. But basically the hard work is already done.
So I did the crease in the outer V first, so basically just apply this to the lid.
We can move on to the bottom lash line and inner corner of the eyelid. And that's how that's looking. This is a very cool tone, really dark brown.
We're going to add some color to this look in just a moment, a pop of color. Yes. So now it's time to highlight the brow bone. And the color I'm going to use to highlight the brow bone is actually this middle shade right here, which is kind of shimmery. And I'm just going to use that on... I'm going to use the same brush, actually, to apply this color to my brow bone. And that's going to help make my brows pop even more. And it's a really, really pretty shadow. I don't even know what it's called. I don't think it has a name. But this one right here. It's a light kind of champagne color. I'm using the same brush. If you apply a little bit too much that I just did on my other eyebrow, or brow bone, that's okay.
Like it got mixed into the eyeshadow. I'm just going to take the brush from the Anastasia palette, and with whatever's left over, just blend that out.
All right. We are done with that. Where am I putting these brushes at? I need to keep all these palettes and stuff for later today. To highlight my inner corner, I know I wanted silver, so I'm going to be using this shadow from Sephora called Diamonds Are Forever. Yes, perfect. That's the name of our show. Or the show. I say our show just because I was there a lot. Just helping with little things, but I'm not one of the producers or anything. I'm just helping with makeup backstage and just helping in general. But I do feel like I'm a part of it. I'm just really excited for it tonight. So this is what we're going to use to highlight our inner corner. And it's perfect because it's called Diamonds Are Forever. Love.
I'm just using this really small brush.
From Coastal Scents. This is like our first shimmer besides the brow bone. Of course, this one comes out good, and this one's just, like, doing its own thing. And, like, having fallout everywhere. Which we don't want. I do not want silver glitter down here. But I may just have to live with it. I hope we watch a movie today in class. I know I'm in college saying that, but because it's music history, there's lots of, like, documentaries about composers and their lives and stuff like that, which are cool. I find cool because I'm kind of nerd. All right, so this is really bothering me how it won't apply, like, how it is here to this side. So to fix that, everything I need is packed away. But I have another little sample of the Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. I got one as a free gift at a Sephora event. So you guys already know what I'm about to do. Spray this brush. Spray the tip of the brush, and that should help this go on a lot easier. There we go. Now we have our diamond.
Yes, for the intense inner corner.
I want them to look like diamonds. There we go. Yes, intense love. Let me throw that in here since it's called Diamonds Are Forever. Somebody else might want that. All right. And let me take this second spray if I need to make eyeshadows more intense with me. I have another one already in there, but it's not full. All right, so we're almost done. So now I'm using this L'Oreal Silk Kissimmee liner in the shade Turquoise. Well, made in the country I was born in, made in Germany, because diamonds are kind of like a turquoise color and emojis, even though they're really clear, sparkly, iridescent. But I want just a pop of color on the bottom lash line, so this is what I'm going to use. And this is super pretty. And these are really, really smooth and easy to apply. Or is the tears coming?
And I have the perfect shadows from either Makeup Forever or Urban Decay that I could apply on top of this, but I'm just going to use the eyeliner pencil. And I'm kind of thickening it up a little bit. Like so. It's 8 o'clock. I'm making good time. I'll be able to make it to Starbucks and to my class. Somebody dropped something. Look how pretty that is. I'm loving how this is turning out. Thank you, Lord, for me having a good makeup day. And so it doesn't look so strange. I'm going to take the brown that I used on my lid and smudge a little bit of that right underneath this Silk Kissimmee liner in turquoise from L'Oreal. And I'm just going to use this same little brush to get under there, and it's from my Smashbox palette. I guess the color's called M1. I didn't even see that on the back of this palette. So the same brow that's applied to my lid, I'm just going to take this, a little bit of that right underneath this Silk Kissimmee liner. And you may not be able to see it on camera. The effect that it has. And then I'm going to apply this liner right in the waterline, just so that it's a little bit brighter, because this is kind of dulling it out just a little bit. And of course, we are going to do some wing liner with this look. It's very fierce. So after you're done blending a little bit of that under your eye, I don't know if y'all can tell the difference that it makes. I feel like it just ties it together a little more. It makes it look a little bit better. I'm going to take that cosmetic wedge and pat it under my eyes. The one that we used to sit underneath. I'm going to take the beauty blender. This look is coming out so pretty. What was I going to do? I remember. So now I need to apply this into the waterline. Scary things. So we're really getting in there, literally. I think it's super smooth and really pigmented because this was really easy and painless. And that's going to help brighten it up a little bit more. Since by adding that brown underneath, it kind of took away from the pop. Alright, so eyeliner. Lord be with me. I have that new eyeliner that I just got, which is Wear. Goodness gracious.
I really like this e.l.f. precision look on her, but it's like almost empty.
But we're gonna go with this. Oh gosh. Okay, so that side made a point.
I feel like I just can't get this to point. And I don't want it to go out forever. So I'm making the actual line for the bottom of the wing first and comparing so that they match to the best of my ability. And then bringing it in. Oh gosh. I'm trying to keep it as close to the lash line as possible, as you can see. Okay. It's not... There we go. Now it's a little bit sharper.
Okay, so now I just need to make it sharper.
There we go. Come to a nice point. There we go. It's not perfect, but that's pretty good. Especially for me. Because I suck at getting them to match, but I think that method I just used is very effective. Alright. Winged eyeliner is on, and that was the e.l.f. Precision Liquid Eyeliner. It has a brush tip. And I really like brush tips. But I don't think they make them anymore because I went to go buy some liquid eyeliner the other day and it wasn't there. That wasn't there. Okay. So, moving on. Mascara. I'm loving the way this look is coming out.
Yes. So fierce.
I see a little gap on here where there was no liquid eyeliner. I want to get the NYC liquid eyeliner, but I never see it when I go shopping. Alright, Caleb, I heard that one's really good. Alright, so eyeliner's on fleek. Mascara, and the mascara I want to use is... Is it packed up? Oh, goodness. Okay. just have to use the benefit they're real. It's the only one I'm seeing that I left up here. Wonder if I have any more left in these. The CoverGirl, the Supersizer. So I'm going to try both of my CoverGirl, the Supersizers first. And then I'll go on with some benefit they're real. But I really wanted to use the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara.
I don't know if there's any mascara left in these. But it seems like barely.
So that one's basically empty. I'm gonna try my other one.
Oh, this one doesn't seem empty. It's always nice to find out that you have a mascara that isn't empty.
So let me throw my empty one away. So this is the CoverGirl, the Supersizer mascara. That's what I'm using.
Oh yeah.
Bomb.com.
I literally got like
the vision for this makeup look while I was sleeping. That's one of my tactics to help myself fall asleep, is to think about what makeup look I'm going to do the next day and exactly what products am I going to use.
And then before I know it, I'm falling asleep. I'm asleep, but I'm a lucid dreamer, so I'm still like thinking about it after I've fallen asleep.
I hope my roommate is awake. She's going to our other roommate's program. She needs to be, like,
leaving soon so she can get a seat, because all those parents and stuff,
they're going to be crazy and fighting you for a seat so they can see their child and all that and all. Oh, goodness. And the traffic and just parking.
People going to work, people taking their kids to school, just all that. She wants to leave early. So she won't be late.
Again, this is the CoverGirl, the Supersizer mascara, and look what it's doing. Look what it has done for these lashes. Like, it's awesome.
Definitely one of my favorites from 2015.
Yes, the fierce news.
And of course, we can't neglect the bottom lashes. I'm being very careful not to cover up the eyeliner.
trying to figure out, as I apply mascara, what I'm going to write about for my next poem. In poetry writing, it has to be a metaphorical poem. That's almost like an allegory, but in poetry form. I'm not an English major, so if anything I'm saying doesn't sound right or isn't quite exactly how it should be said, I ain't no English major. I'm the only non-English major in that class. But she wants it to be like an extended metaphor. So not like we are grass, grass is green, blah, 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 people, blah, 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 or we die and we come back and spring fresh, and blah, blah, blah. It has to be an extended metaphor, so you never really state exactly what you're... metaphor means, people should be able to figure that out from the poem.
So I'm not sure. I was thinking about writing about humans as diamonds. Like talking about how we're like coal, which is like dirty and nasty, and nobody really wants coal. But you know, when we're refined by the fire of stuff. I'm trying to allude it to Christianity, like, but when God works with us and molds with us and tries us and does everything that he needs to do and crushes us to build us back up, then we become a beautiful diamond. And we're something that's admired and something that's a light to the world, biblical. So I don't know if I want to do that, or I was thinking... last night, I was at the desk having people help me take my braids out. And we were talking about, one of my friends is like in a racial identity class, and they're talking about like black identity, and I was telling him about my black identity issues or whatever, or just my identity as a black woman. And he brought up like America. He doesn't think of America as a melting pot. He thinks of it as a soup. And I said, yes, I agree with that. We are like a heterogeneous mixture. So I might want to write about that, how America is a soup, not a melting pot. Because in a soup, you still have all your separate ingredients. You can pick out your separate ingredients, even though they're all together in the same bowl. Kind of like this country. This mascara is giving me so much life right now. I'm so glad I just digged through my bowl thing. Alright, so I have mascara on. Okay, we've done everything for this look except for lips. So for lips, I definitely want something nude because the eyes are kind of the focus, even though they're not super duper duper intense, they are the focus. So the nude lip I want to wear today is, I'm not sure, this might be interesting. It's a frosty color. Do I want a matte lip? I think I want a matte lip. I just really like matte lips. I'll probably end up wearing ColourPop Tulle or Beeper later today, but since I have to like play saxophone and practice and stuff, for now I think I'm just going to put on this Black Radiance lip gloss in Whisper Pink. Which it's not matte. It's pretty.
So that completes this makeup look for now. Like I said, I might change the lip color later. I'm pretty sure I will. Oh gosh, my throat. To a matte lipstick just because it's long lasting. I know it's gonna stay. It's not gonna get on my teeth. It's not going nowhere. So, I know this video was extremely long, but you got to see how I created this look, which I am loving. And again, thank you for watching. Thanks for your support. I hope you guys enjoy this too. I know it's like, this is my longest one in a while, but I'm gonna put my head wrap on, throw on some clothes just for now because I'm gonna be resting before this fashion show is practice rest. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye, YouTube.